HKM TV presents Girls Varsity Basketball. Tonight we have a big TBL matchup for you. The 15-2 Hopkinton Hillers host the 14-4 Westwood Wolverines. Hi, I'm Tim Ladek here with my partner Steve Spector tonight. And Steve, last time we saw Hopkinton play Westwood, they had a one-point victory in Westwood.
Yeah, and I'm sure Westwood's come in here looking for some sweet revenge and really, you know, big playoff implications and Tri-Valley League implications going on tonight. If the Hiller girls win tonight, they clinch the Tri-Valley League championship, which is a great honor.
Absolutely.
And Westwood's looking to make that not happen and take over. So we'll see how the game goes. It's going to be a very exciting Friday night here.
Such actions, including taunting, trash-talking, and the berating of players or officials, will not be tolerated. The Tri-Valley League has adopted a zero-tolerance policy. Warnings will not be issued, and offenders will be ejected. Please respect all decisions made by officials. Please respect fans, coaches, participants, and opponents alike. And now, the lineups for this evening's game. For the Westwood Wolverines, starting at guard, number 21, sophomore Fiona McGowan. Starting at forward, number 13, junior Elizabeth Kelly. Starting at forward, number 3, senior captain Carly Shabrew. Starting at guard, number 4, senior captain Allie Morin. Starting at guard, number 10, senior captain Haley Connaughton. Coach for the Wolverines is Catherine Clifford. And now for your hometown Hopkinton Hillers. Starting at guard, number 23, sophomore Lily Morningstar. Starting at guard, number 10, senior Julia Canastrari. Starting at forward, number 44, junior captain Ivy Gogolin. Starting at guard, number 12, senior captain Emma Lacasha. Starting at forward, number 31, captain Michaela Pucci. The coaches for the Hillers are Mike Greco, Kristen Malviga, and Perry Chapman. And now would you all please rise for the playing of our national anthem.
As you said before the break, the Hillers have a chance to clinch the TVL here with a win tonight. With a loss, they would be tied with Medfield. But again, with that win, they would clinch. And if my eyes don't deceive me, it looks from across the stadium here, we can see the last time the Hiller girls won the TVL was in 2006. So a pretty big occasion here for the Hillers.
It is. It's a good opportunity. A lot of green in the building. Westwood's colors are also green, and I'm partial to the little hint of orange to distinguish it, but this is going to be a big Friday night game here. Definitely the biggest game of the season for the Hiller girls, and I'm sure they're fired up. There's a big crowd here, and we got Mike Tiger Tarosian directing and doing the camera. That's always a good thing, so we're in good hands. So here we go.
All right, tip-off moment away. Ball is up and controlled by the Hillers. Again, starting quick, Poochie pass to Candace Jarvis. She can't finish. Goglin offensive board. Another board. She can't finish now. Poochie gets it back again and is fouled. Three quick offensive rebounds there for the Hillers.
Jeez, and in 10 seconds, there's four shots to the hoop. That's their patented opening play, and they've got that down pretty good. Unfortunately, Julia missed the layup, but we have a couple free throws here. So
maybe a bit of jitters there for Michaela Poochie. That one a bit hard off the backboard. Second one coming up. Off the back of the rim again. Still a 0-0 game. Allison Morin controlling the ball for Westwood. Hockington out in basic man-to-man defense here to start things off. Morningstar,
nice
great defense, takes it away. Now she's on the break, finds Canestrari. Nice step inside. Can't hit the layup, but another foul and two more free throws coming for Hockington.
Nice play by Lily Morningstar coming back from her shin splints. I know she was out for a game or two, and she did a good job keeping her composure on the break, a 2-on-1. She laid it right off to Julia, and she made a nice play to the hoop, got fouled, and she's hit the first of two shots.
First point of the game thus far, 30 seconds in. Off the back rim for Canestrari. Poochie, another offensive board. She can't finish. And grabbed by Elizabeth Kelly of Westwood.
Yeah, those free throws early, as we talked about earlier,
right.
Hopefully that won't be an issue later on.
If there's been one Achilles heel for this Hiller team, it's been their free throw shooting. Yeah. Drive and shot from Connaughton. No good. Grabbed by Poochie. Now Morningstar with it. Finds Canestrari wide open for the layup. Lily Morningstar facilitating. Canestrari with the bucket.
Nice play. Nice finish.
Canestrari reads that pass.
Nice steal.
Takes it away. Now Poochie looks up. Finds Morningstar. She gets blocked by Shagru. Great play. And now Morin is on the drive. Passes it right to Goglin, who tries to save it right into the hands of Morin, who misses the up and under. Now Goglin takes it the other way.
Oh, that looked like some contact there.
Turns right into Shagru, can't finish the shot. And now Connaughton with it for Westwood.
Ivy made up her mind. She was going to the hoop there.
Yep. Morningstar on Morin. She often draws the toughest assignment as far as defense goes.
That's going to be a good battle tonight. You can see that. Ooh, that looked like a little walk there.
Two steps and 2 points for Fiona McGowan.
Certainly a nice shot, though.
First bucket of the game for Westwood. Westwood also in basic man-to-man defense here to start things out.
It's a loud gym here tonight. Can hear everything through these headphones here.
Morningstar looking for a cutting Poochie, turns it over. Shagu drives, takes the contact, can't finish. Goglin with the defense and the rebound.
Refs are letting the play so far.
Morningstar thought about the three.
Oh, nice.
Great pass to Canestrari. Lily Morningstar.
She's got
another assist.
She would have three assists. She's got two. Well, she got Julie got fouled on one of them. There's some.
Lakasha gets caught.
Haley Connaughton.
Hit with a blocking foul.
I think it's Connaughton.
Connaughton.
Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. She made up her mind as well. She's going to the hoop, and there's definitely been some contact, and certainly makes for a better game when the refs let the players play in general, but that was a little bit too much to let go on that particular play.
First free throw for Westwood is no good. Connaughton hits the back of the rim.
You can see there's a fast-paced game already with just a couple minutes into the game, 5:21 left in the first, as compared to some of the more recent games where a little more energy in the building tonight.
Connaughton misses the free throw, got the offensive, Westwood got the offensive rebound, and then on her three-point attempt, she traveled. So a turnover for Westwood, and the Hillers maintain a 5-2 lead with 5:16 left in the first quarter. Goglin gets it down low. She turns and fires. Looks like that might have been partially blocked by Shagru. But again, Michaela Poochie working the offensive glass.
That's her game. Michaela down low. Just really good body position there. And really, the Westwood girl had no business doing anything. on that shot.
Another traveling violation on Westwood, this one on Elizabeth Kelly. And Westwood makes the first substitution of the game. Christina Bonfiglio enters the game, the senior. And LaCasha brings it up for Hopkinton. Trying to get it down low to Gogolin. Loose ball that ends up in the hands of Pucci, and she gets another basket inside.
Boy, nice ball fake. Drew a couple of the Westwood Wolverines in the air, and then she took it to the hoop for two. Really nice play. Nine to two lead.
Westwood not having much luck here, probing the defense. Morin drives, kicks it out. Three-point corner line. Three-point shot, no good from Bonfiglio. Knocked out of bounds, and the Hillers take over.
Westwood having trouble finding the ocean, as they say early here. With 4 minutes left in the first, they have one bucket. 9-2, Hiller lead.
Loose ball grabbed by LaCasha, tried to get it into Pucci. Nice cut by Morningstar. Better pass from LaCasha, but...
Nice block.
Yep, better block by Westwood. Connaughton steps into the three, knocks it down.
That was a nice stroke there.
She's not afraid to shoot it.
Yeah, I'm sure she's going to take a few more as the night gets along.
9-5 lead now for Hopkinton. 3:30 left in the first period. First quarter, excuse me. Gogolin, nice pass from Pucci. She can't finish. Now Westwood on the break.
Ooh. Pass right in the front row. I don't think that was intended to go there, but get some substitutions here.
An errant pass there, to say the least, from Carly Chagrou. That one awarded to Hopkinton.
So we've got Kate Huebner in the game, 5'5" junior guard. Callie Corby, 5'6" junior guard. Good to see them in the game here. They've had some great seasons so far.
Keaveney also in the game. That pass to her, knocked out of bounds by Bonfiglio. Stays with Hopkinton. Now,
pretty deep bench they got here. They keep on bringing people in here.
Yeah, both. I think this might be the first time all year we've seen a game between the Hillers and someone else who've actually matched their depth on the bench.
Exactly. They look like Westwood's got a deep bench as well. They have an impressive record, so takes a village, as they say.
The Hillers make it a concerted effort to get it into Gogolin, but Westwood responding and often doubling Gogolin down low, and that's caused a few turnovers. Another one there.
Oh, nice pass.
Morin, the nice pass. Riley Murray with a two-point bucket.
Sophomore. That was a nice left hand there.
Corby hounded by Morin there. She gets it into Pucci. Keaveney fires the three. Knocks it down.
That's a good sign coming off the bench. She's in the game for 30 seconds, and she launches a three, hits the bottom of the net. Beautiful shot.
Morin drives, gets right through.
Nice play.
No help defense there at all for the Hillers as Morin cruises right past for the bucket. 12-9 lead now for Hopkinton. Gogolin calling for it. Doesn't get it.
Like a walk, yep.
Now Keaveney tried to step through a double team, ended up walking. A turnover there for the Hillers.
Fast-paced first quarter. 2 minutes left, 12-9.
Yeah, not many whistles at all.
Oh, there you go. There's a timeout, the first timeout of the game. Westwood was down 9-2 at one point. Now they're down 12-9, so they've made a little bit of a surge. As these things go, the game of momentum changes, and I think we're off to – you can see there's going to be an old-fashioned shootout, I think, you know.
Right, and as you mentioned, Steve, we have a pretty raucous environment here tonight. The past few games, Hopkinton, not to belabor the other teams in the TVL, but Hopkinton has had some pretty big wins recently, and the games just haven't had the same type of feel that tonight has.
No, you can definitely feel the energy, and, you know, some of these past few games, as you said, have been 20 and 30 point blowouts, and it's – hate to say that they've been over at halftime, but you can kind of – sort of a foregone conclusion by then. And Coach Greco did a great job getting a lot of players in the game, including some JV players. And tonight's going to probably be a little different game. We can see it's going to be a tight track meet out there, you know.
Yeah, and this type of game will surely benefit Hopkinton in the long run, even if they don't win. Because a game like this is going to be the type of teams that they see coming up in the postseason.
Yeah, it's good. They're going to get some competition, get them ready for the playoffs in a couple weeks.
But the Hiller girls are responding well so far, holding a three-point lead with just 2 minutes left here in the first. And now Westwood looking to shorten that lead.
Nice block.
The drive Julia. From Riley Murray, blocked from behind by Gogolin. Canestrari gets it to her down low. She turns and is fouled from behind. Looks like that one's on Carly Chagrou.
They say before the shot.
Yep. Looks like as the Hillers will inbound.
Ivy's coming out and Michaela's coming in. Nice to, nice luxury to have that kind of
right.
depth, you know.
Hillers were looking for a three there in the last few passes. No one pulled the trigger. Now trying to work the offense more. Keaveney. Canestrari finally pulls the trigger, knocks it down.
That was from the parking lot, a few feet behind the line. That was a nice shot. Beautiful.
Now a 15-9 lead for Hopkinton.
Julia has the capability of heating up quick.
Connaughton controlling the ball now as Morin is off the court for Westwood. McGowan has the ball stripped. Ends up in the hands of Canestrari. Canestrari takes a deep three.
Oh.
Knocks it down.
She's feeling it. That was why I appreciate her hitting that shot, because I kind of called it if I don't want to take, you know, be self-serving here. But no, that, as I said, she can heat up quick.
Nice move inside from Elizabeth Kelly. She can't finish on the shot. Corby grabs it. Now Hopkinton on the run.
Seconds left in the quarter.
About a two-second difference from the shot clock and the game clock. Poochie drives, puts her head down, and draws contact. No good on the shot, but two more free throws coming.
Well, there's a lot of scoring going on here. The Hillers are averaging around 60 points a game, which is very few teams in the state average 60 points a game. There are a handful, but not very many, and they're off to
right.
a faster pace than that right now, on a more of an 80-point pace.
Yeah, about. It helps when
see my math skills? You see my math skills there?
I did see that. Very good.
Thank you very much.
But when Canestrari hits threes like that, it's easy to rack up those points.
I'll tell you, it's. I think Westwood's needs to gather themselves if they're going to hang around at this pace. And we'll see if the Hillers can continue their pace.
Morin back in the game for Westwood. She controls the ball again. Westwood looking for a three.
3 seconds.
Morin's going to take it just off the front rim, and that does it here in the first quarter. Hillers enjoy a 10-point lead going into the second.
Jeez, that's great. Great start. A lot of energy. You can, like I said, you can feel the energy. There's parents and students everywhere here. Even the Westwood turnout is pretty impressive.
Good,
yep. You got to give them credit coming a few towns over, and I think the Hillers, Coach Greco's got to be pleased so far with a 10-point lead on a team like Westwood. So kudos to the Hiller girls so far.
Right, we've seen Hopkinton beat their opponents in a multitude of ways, and usually always they can rely on the inside presence of Ivy Gogolin and Michaela Pucci, who have shown up thus far. But in addition to that, they also have the three-point shot clicking. And when that happens, we have the result that we see here, a 10-point lead. And it looks like it's going to grow by the look at things.
We'll see. We hope that happens. And, you know, a big part of that at the last minute or two of the quarter was Julia Canestrari hitting two bombs from the right hash mark and then from the top of the key. Both shots were well beyond the arc. And both of them didn't hit anything but net. So I think Westwood coach Catherine Clifford, she's got to come up with a different, you know, approach. Maybe put somebody different on her. You've got to toughen up the D there.
Right. And Westwood starts the second quarter with possession. Shagru drives baseline. Pass too high for Amanda Nocera, and it goes out of bounds. Another turnover for the Wolverines. Play in there looks to be to get to Gogolin. Good defense down low.
Nice.
Morningstar drives right by her defender with a scoop layup. Lily Morningstar her presence felt.
She's probably got some pent-up energy. She's missed a couple games at least. I don't know how many exactly, but at least a couple with her shin splint. Well, there's a travel. But she's coming out like wildfire tonight with some two or three really nice assists, and that was a beautiful take to the hoop.
Allison Moore and the senior captain hit with a traveling violation there. Several of those already for Westwood thus far. Hawkinton leads 21-9. And Kana Strari draws a foul at the three-point line. And Hawkinton will inbound.
Christina Bonfiglio of Westwood getting a little too aggressive there.
Yeah, her first
foul. But they need to do that because they got to toughen things up.
Pucci gets it into Gogolin. She can't hit. Rebounded by Bonfiglio.
Got a 5-1 difference in fouls so far, which is Westwood with five fouls, so that's a little different situation there.
Bonfiglio thought about the three, nice behind the back.
Oof.
Knocks down the bank shot. Great play there by Bonfiglio.
That was pretty sweet. Little spinneroo.
Little razzle dazzle.
But really nice move. Nice finish.
Morningstar finds Gogolin. The open shot. She can't finish, but crashing the boards and drawing the foul. Ivy Gogolin.
She's fired up tonight, too. I mean,
she hasn't been shooting well, but the effort is there. And she's working the offensive glass.
Well, she released that first shot. I think she knew immediately there was going to be a little bit off, and she anticipated where it was going to go. And to her credit, she grabbed that offensive rebound and got whacked going up for the rebound on the offensive rebound, and she hits the first of two.
Second one, no good.
Nice box out by Elizabeth Kelly.
I was about to say, usually Pucci grabs that one, yep. But not that time. Bonfiglio with it now for Westwood. Almost gets the ball taken away. Morin fires the two. Deep two, no good.
Good box off by LaCascia. LaCascia
grabs the board. Morningstar with it now. LaCascia barking out the orders there, trying to get inside to Gogolin again. But good defense there from Elizabeth Kelly. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. And Shagru hit another foul. Canastari draws another foul. This one on Shagru at the three-point line.
I think that might be a 1-1.
Yeah, it looks like as Canastari sets up at the free throw line.
There's a lot of contact there. That was right in front of the ref. It was hard not to call that one. 7-1 discrepancy in fouls. I don't know how the...
Big disparity there.
Coach Clifford of Westwood, she's remaining calm at the moment. But that's the way it's gone. I think the refs are calling a good game so far. And
right. I mean, that is a big disparity, like you said. But it hasn't seemed too bad. Like, I haven't been shaking my head at any calls or anything. I think Westwood's just being a little too aggressive trying to come back here.
Well, I think a lot of it has to do with dealing with the big three. You know, a lot of the 6'1" players that Hoppington's throwing. A nice shot. I mean, Hoppington's got a lot of tall players, and they're skilled. And eventually, if you're in a helpless situation, you have to foul.
McGowan with the hard floater off the backboard. Two more points there for Westwood. Now Westwood has switched to a zone, trying to negate the impact of Gogolin and Pucci inside. Ball stripped by Bonfiglio. She takes it all the way. Shot too hard. Morin and Pucci fighting for it.
Bodies flying everywhere.
Eventually, Morningstar gets on it. And a jump ball is called.
Good hustle by both teams there. Lily Morningstar, she's only a sophomore. She's got quite a future ahead of her. And good to have her back. He's definitely added some energy tonight so far.
Pucci harassed at half court. Draws a foul there.
It's another one-on-one situation.
Another foul on Fiona McGowan. Rather, that's her first foul.
And that one was a little bit, I won't say questionable, but I don't think the Westwood coaching staff was too
pleased.
In agreement with that one. But that could have gone either way. And I think they were looking for a backcourt violation because I think...
Right, her foot did step on the line, yep. But foul called, and she sinks two free throws. 13-point lead now for Hopkinton. 4:40 left in the half.
Oof. And a tough pass.
Another turnover there. McGowan tried to hit Gabriella Haney-Secord with a bounce pass. Secord could not control it. Another turnover there. And Westwood looking a bit out of sorts here.
So far, so good, and Coach Greco's feeling pretty good. You never want to get too complacent or too comfortable, but because there's a lot of things can change real quickly. But Westwood's throwing the ball around a little bit, and that last pass was just bounce pass into the feet of their player. So
Bonfiglio steps back for three after a Hopkinton turnover. No good. Joglin grabs the rebound.
She's not shy. She's been launching him up a little bit, but she's hit a few too.
Pass inside to
nice
Gogolin,
play.
Turns, shot, knocks it down. Ivy Gogolin not shooting particularly well tonight, but confident nonetheless, knocks down that tough turnaround jumper.
That was a beautiful play. She took the pass to her was not right dead on, and she reached a mile to
another
get it.
Another rebound there for Gogolin off the missed three from Morin. Canestrari wants it in the corner. She gets it, fires the three.
Oof.
A gasp from the crowd there as she misses. Kiviny, offensive board, no. Another chance for her. And it looks like Haney Secord knocked it out of bounds, but apparently it already touched out of bounds off of a Hiller.
Yeah, they're having a conference over there. They don't have the instant replay or...
the Jumbotron to look up at.
They're talking about it. The summit meeting of sorts over there, but they just want to get it right. It
looks like they're going to keep it as Westwood ball.
15-point lead with 3:33 left in the half. So far, so good here, Tim.
And another thing to note here in this first half, Hopkinton has to have double digits in offensive rebounds. They've really been working the offensive glass here against Westwood. Haney Secord for three, too strong. Offensive rebound, though, for Caroline Bean. She fires a three, no good. Gets her own rebound. Morin open. She launches a three.
Ooh.
Finally knocks that one down. The deep three for the captain, Morin.
They kind of needed that one. Not that I'm rooting for them, but they hadn't had a basket in a while.
Canestrari trapped. Gets the ball ripped away. And that one, the Westwood coaching staff not too pleased with.
Yeah, there's
and that one I would say was an iffy call. That looked like good defense there, and Canestrari kind of got bailed out there.
I would have to agree with you there.
And more free throws coming.
You know, this 9-1, only one foul in the half. The half is not quite over, but I haven't seen a lot of Hiller fouls, and that's not a homer,
right.
You know, commentary or anything. That's the reality of it.
And there we have one. I just think Westwood's foul shouldn't be as high. I think the Hillers fouls are right where they should be, but Westwood has been hit with a few questionable ones.
I agree with you.
And that one now, maybe a makeup call there, I think, on Pucci. Not much contact there, but a foul called. Now Westwood takes over. Morningstar getting up to come back in for the final 2 minutes. Pass inside. To Riley Murray, and another foul called, and looks like the refs are trying to erase that disparity pretty quick now.
Well, the Westwood bench erupted on that foul, which was sort of a Bronx cheer situation. We're like, about time there was a call made, but that was my interpretation of what I just saw there. But oh, there you go.
Pass right to Morningstar by herself. Takes it down the length of the court and
nice
knocks
play.
It down. Lily Morningstar.
She had Riley Murray coming up from behind there. Pretty tall player, and Lily kept her composure. Nice finish there.
Probably the easiest steal she's ever had, but the layup, tough, and she makes it. Now another offensive rebound there for Westwood. Morin steps back for three off the front rim. Gogolin, another rebound.
Oof.
Throws it right back into the hands of Morin. Jump shot from her, no good. Lakasha can't rip the ball away.
It's a foul
on
Emma.
With a foul.
All of a sudden, we spoke too soon.
Yeah,
there's been
right.
About four fouls in a row on the Hillers. That was Emma's second foul, so might want to think about that. Coach Greco might make an adjustment there. But
well, he's got plenty of depth on the bench if he chooses to go there.
Definitely.
Warren with it at the three-point line. Dishes
oh,
over. Nice
play.
Pass back from number 23, Riley Murray, to Morin, who hits the layup. Great pass to open that up. Gogolin open down
nice
low.
Nice block, too.
She turns, can't finish. Bonfiglio with it now for Westwood.
It's kind of a critical juncture in the game for Westwood. Down by 12 with about a minute and a half to go in the half. I'm sure they want to tighten the score before halftime.
Bonfiglio with it. Now Morin thought about the three.
Tough D.
She drives.
Oh!
Kanastari got the ball, but also knocked her in the head a little bit from behind. Two shots coming there for the senior captain, Morin.
We got timeout by Westwood. Not a bad timeout. You have them to use, and there's still enough time where, as I said a minute ago, there's a if they can get this lead down under 10 points before, or whatever they can do,
right,
before the half, and they want to try to...
They'd still be very much in the game forward.
Get some strategy behind that in the next minute and 24 seconds before halftime. And they have a couple foul shots to maybe bring it to 10.
Mm-hmm.
And, the Hillers, things have calmed down. They had a 19-9 lead after one.
Right.
And... still, similarly,
things have cooled down a little bit here.
A little bit, they haven't.
Hillers.
Well, as you've seen, we saw Julia hit 2 3-point bombs in the last minute of the first quarter. So, after scoring 19 in the first quarter, they've only scored 11 so far. So Westwood's tightened things up, and it's been sort of an even second quarter so far.
We'll see what Coach Greco has the Hillers ready for as they come back onto the floor after this timeout. Westwood with free throws coming.
Maybe we can take a minute here as everybody's coming on board. We can thank our amazing staff who keeps everything running smoothly here. Our producers, John Ritz, Mike Tiger Tarosian, director Tom Dings, graphics Samantha Dings, and our camera crew is John Ritz, Andy Ritz, and Mike Tarosian again. So thanks, guys. You guys do an awesome job all the time.
Morin misses that first one. Second one up and no good. Gogolin, another rebound.
That's too bad for Westwood. Kind of a break for Hoppington to miss two. Ooh. That's a double bonus, 10th foul.
Kanastari walking a little gingerly after that fall.
I think that was an inadvertent trip, but it was a trip nevertheless.
It was a foul, yep.
Yep.
Kanastari with two free throws now. Hoppington in the double bonus. Her first one off the back rim. Emma Lakasha takes a seat.
I mean, it's a smart substitution with a little over a minute to go in the half. You don't want to have Emma pick up a third foul somewhere, in the next minute. So Kate Huber's in there.
Kanastari knocks the second free throw down. 31-18. Just over a minute left here in the first half. Hoppington still in man-to-man defense. Deep two-point shot. No good from Amanda Nocera. And another rebound for Ivy Gogolin. Morningstar thought about the three. and hit with another traveling call. A few of those here in the game for both teams.
Yeah, exactly. That's just unfortunate. And NBA, that never happened. Those calls are all non-traveling calls, but they're high school, they are. So.
35 seconds left here in the first half. 15 left on the shot clock for Westwood. Bonfiglio trying to work her magic.
She's got some shake and bake to her game there, a little swagger there, you know.
Pass inside, Kelly can't get it to go. Morningstar grabs the rebound. Or Murray with that shot, excuse me. Ball knocked out of bounds, still belongs to the Hillers.
Substitution. Oh, Emma's coming back in with 16 seconds left.
Yep, 16.2 seconds left. Shot clock off. Hillers have a chance to hold it for the final shot of the first half, up 13. Kanastari launches the three. Bit too strong. Rebounded by Westwood. Bonfiglio.
Good try from a three-quarters court. Longer than that. It was in the neighborhood, but
good if it goes, but it did not go. And here at the end of the first half, the Hillers enjoying a comfortable, but not too comfortable, 13-point lead.
Well, they, you know, again, they scored a whole bunch of points in the first quarter, so it would be hard to expect them to continue that pace. But they did slow it down. They got 12 points in the second quarter, so they, you know, they're at 31-18 halftime lead. And I'll tell you what, I think we're going to have a game here in the second half, so we're excited to be here. And everybody stay tuned for what's going to be a good second half.
Yeah, we'll see you guys in a few minutes after the halftime break. Stay tuned.
Do you have what it takes?
Will you make a difference?
Always an adventure.
Police and fire working together.
Utilizing the latest technology.
Do you have what it takes?
Hi, welcome to Break Gardens.
Just make sure that you water regularly and through November.
So I think we can go ahead and start backfilling here.
I think fall is one of the best times to plant roses.
When you can squeeze your soil and hold it together, that's good.
Johnny.
Tim Hladek back with Steve Spector here for the second half of this highly anticipated TVL bout between Hopkinton Hillers and the Westwood Wolverines. Hopkinton enjoying a 31-18 lead here at the start of the second half. But as it goes on, I expect things might get a little bit closer, Steve.
Yeah, we'll see. I mean, Westwood, I'm sure they haven't forgot about that first game where Hopkinton went down to Westwood and snuck out with a one-point victory.
Right.
And they didn't really come out to do any – they stayed in their locker room as long as they possibly could. They didn't take any warm-ups. We'll see how the second half goes, but I'm sure they're going to be fired up to try to close this gap a little bit.
Something to watch here, too, in the second half, the foul disparity between both teams. Let's see if it's a little bit more even than it was in the first half. In any event, Westwood starts off with possession down 13. Morin looked like she was going to shoot the three. Connaughton fires off the front of the rim, grabbed by Gogolin. She continues her torrid rebounding pace. Canestrari fires it inside. Pucci muscles it up, gets fouled by Shagru. Excuse me, fouled by Elizabeth Kelly.
Yeah, there was definitely some contact on the forearm there. And Pucci's got two shots. Let's get to start the second half. See if they can get a little, you know, the foul shooting, as we said earlier in other games, can be contagious both ways. So she hits the first one. That's always a good sign.
Quick sub already for Westwood as Kelly takes a seat. Third foul.
Yeah, that's right? A big she's had a pretty good game. I mean, Westwood's got a deep team, and that's anyone with three fouls at this point for either team is got to be not a good development with the whole second half in front of us.
Second free throw rims out for Pucci. Now Westwood looking to answer on the offensive end. Three-point shot from Connaughton. Ooh. That one hits the mark. Now an 11-point lead for Hopkinton. Morin gets in front of Morningstar's pass.
Nice play.
Collects herself and knocks down the deuce.
Could be a quick timeout here. But they're okay. Still done. Still got a 9-point lead
now,
here.
Now in the single digits, though.
Yep.
For Westwood for the first time since the first quarter.
You can see they're fired up. They're playing a swarming kind of a trapping defense, looking for traps.
Pucci drives.
What a move that was.
Had Morningstar open, didn't look up and find her, but still draws a foul and a chance for Hillers to get some points here on this possession.
Well, that was a nice sneaky little move by Michaela. She kind of slithered in between a couple of players and pick up another foul.
Pucci with four quick free throws here to start things off. Two of three so far. Here comes the fourth. And she knocks it down. Back to an 11-point lead for Hopkinton. Shagru fires the three.
Oof.
Knocks it down. Westwood coming out firing.
All of a sudden, it's 8 points.
Morningstar, great pass. Gogolin drives through, knocks down the bucket. Lily Morningstar facilitating for the Hopkinton Hillers.
That's a beautiful feed. She had an open shot, but she gave it up for a better shot. Unselfish.
Jump shot fired. No good from Westwood. Morningstar on the break again. Great pass again to Gogolin, who draws the foul. Morningstar really just providing a huge spark for this Hiller offense.
Well, she's got wheels, and I guess that shin splint thing is a distant memory at this point.
Her now.
And she's definitely really nice composure, taking the ball up, kept her, you know, control, and made a really well-timed pass to Ivy. And she definitely got whacked going on the way up.
First free throw off the mark there for Gogolin.
There's three quick fouls in the beginning of the second half, only 2 minutes in. So that could be have some impact on the game later as they get the 1-1 and double bonus. Ooh, nice.
Gogolin anticipates the pass. Great pass from Gogolin to Morningstar.
Oh.
And Morningstar.
I'd have to disagree with that call, sir. No disrespect. I'm not going to I don't want to be disrespect. I don't want him to feel like I disrespected him because he's a big dude down there. But that was not. I didn't see. Well, I didn't see the travel.
Lily did tap her chest as if to say, "My bad." So, she didn't seem too mad about it. In any event, Westwood takes over after the turnover. Step back three from Shagrew off the mark. Gogolin, another rebound.
Dude, that's her third foul on 23. Riley Murray, sophomore. She's got to get her out of there now because she's got three fouls.
We don't have the numbers in front of us, but I have to imagine Gogolin is around 15 rebounds, if not more. She's really just been grabbing anything, defensive, offensive, whatever she can get her hands on.
She's a machine out there at the moment.
Morningstar dribbles herself into trouble, gets out. Lakasha changes course. Cross-court pass to Morningstar. Now Canestrari gets it back and fires her own three. Oh. Knocks it down. Julia Canestrari, no conscience from deep.
Wow, and she had a hand in her face too. Unconscious at the moment. That's her third three of the night.
Bonfiglio drives into a multitude of Hillers. Foul called, and she will be shooting two.
That looks like it's on Emma.
That would be her third, and it is. Something for Coach Greco to think about moving forward here.
This number 15, Christina Bonfiglio, at the line shooting two. She's definitely not afraid to take things in her own hands. And
she's had some pretty fancy moves thus far.
Yep.
Some nice turnaround jumpers, spin moves as she knocks down that first one. Second one good as well, 40-28. As Emma Lakasha takes a seat with that third foul. And Westwood has come out firing here, but to the Hillers' credit, they've answered it and kept the lead about even.
It's a game of runs, and again, if the Hillers start launching three-pointers.
Nice pass, Gogolin to Canestrari from three. No good. Gogolin, another rebound. Muscles towards the hoop. Knocks it down. Ivy Gogolin has just been unstoppable on the glass. There again. Shagrew with a nice drive. Splits the defense. Fouled on the floor, referee says.
Boy, this is a tough lineup for anybody to deal with. You know, the Hillers have highly skilled big girls. Their guards have quickness and composure. And they have a lot of chemistry going on at the same time.
And in comes another three-point shooter in Regan Keaveney. Doesn't get any easier.
She hasn't been in as much, but she came in and launched one earlier, as I recall. So
tough defense there from Corby on Connaughton. Now Bonfiglio hit with the travel. Coach Clifford not debating that one. Another turnover there for Westwood.
Yeah, the Hiller defense kind of caused that. She kind of got swarmed by a couple Hiller girls, and she lost her composure on that and had to travel.
Morningstar throws it right into the hands of Westwood, but Keaveney ends up with the ball and another traveling call. That one, I might have to voice a complaint on. That
easy,
one
easy, big fella. No, I don't know what the record number of traveling calls is in a high school game.
We're approaching it.
We're getting there.
Morin now with the shake and bake. Decides to kick it back out. Ooh. Pass inside from Connaughton to no one, it looks like, and out of bounds. Turnover there for Westwood.
Yeah, a little miscommunication there. Good idea, and the her teammate didn't really see the pass coming and went right out of bounds. So
now Westwood, another traveling call. Canestrari thought she got fouled. And another traveling call there.
I think the Hiller.
Some mock cheers.
Yeah, the Hiller fans in the stands are expressing their opinion about all these traveling calls. That one was another questionable one, but I'll say this.
Nice block there from Keaveney on the drive from Morin.
They've been fairly consistent. They're calling it tight. Earlier they were letting things go foul-wise, but and there's one there.
Morningstar forces the issue, drives and throws up the floater. Shagrew not happy with the foul call there. Her third as well. Westwood quickly racking up fouls here.
down 14. I mean, again, it's a critical stage of the game for both teams. Again, the free throw shooting is critical. You don't want to leave the door open at all for Westwood to get on a run and get this thing tighter. Right now, it's a fairly comfortable 14-point lead with 3.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Plenty of time left for all sorts of things to go on here.
Again, the Hillers struggling a bit here from the line. Could be as much as a 20-point lead. Now just 15. Westwood, again on offense, trying to change that here as Bonfiglio sets up the offense. Steps back, launches the jumper, knocks it down.
Nice shot. There's a little swagger when I'm going back, and understandably so. She's definitely, for Westwood to get in the game, she's going to be part of the comeback. She's a nice player.
Corby, not sure what to do with it, finds Canestrari. Now she's trapped. Thrown down there by Kelly, but a jump ball already called stays with Hopkinton.
I think there was a bit of a body slam, but it was after the jump ball was called. But maybe I'm embellishing a little, but
she did throw it in.
There was a definitely aggressive defensive play there.
Looks like they're making sure the possession arrow is correct. Some confusion there. Stays with Hopkinton.
Carly Chagrou of Westwood has 3 fouls. It's worth noting. She's one of their captains.
Pass inside. Morningstar, another assist as Gogolin finds her spot in the middle of the lane.
Ivy did a great job. She got the ball right around eye level, didn't bring the ball down, quick release. No chance for Westwood to deal with that. Look at the double team
now
at the top.
Tough defense here from the Hillers, forcing the ball out of Morin's hands. A double again now on Bonfiglio. Maybe a push off, not called, and she airballs a shot, grabbed by Morningstar. Morningstar looks up, finds Canestrari, who takes it all the way.
She's got a ton of points. She's going to have about 15 points so far tonight.
Hillers getting key contributions from everywhere, it seems like. Another assist there for Morningstar. Morin launches a three, knocks it down. The three-point shot keeping Westwood in this game. Timeout, Westwood.
Yeah, barely, though. Good point. But that was a huge shot for them. They really haven't been doing much.
Right. It seems like the game's teetering on the edge of.
It's certainly a well. Both teams are playing about even this quarter, which is not good enough for Westwood. They need to tighten things up.
They can't have even.
But Hopkinton had been pulling away the last few minutes and expanded the lead to 17. And with that three-pointer, it's a 14-point lead for the Hillers during this timeout with 2 minutes left in the third quarter.
Well, we've had great performances here tonight from Canestrari, especially from deep for her. Ivy Gogolin on the boards and scoring as well. She struggled earlier from the field, but did not stop her from being aggressive or grabbing rebounds. She must be close to a double-double now, and Lily Morningstar has really filled the facilitator role quite nicely. A couple really nice assists, some great layups for her as well, and really just a three-headed monster operating right now for Hopkinton. That's not even counting the input of Michaela Pucci.
Yeah, that's a tough four or five players that, you know, we Regan Keaveney coming in off the bench and doing a great job too, and not to mention Callie Corby and Kate Huebner. Total team effort so far.
Hopkinton passing the ball around, trying to break this zone.
Good
players
sportsmanship.
Fall down. So a jump ball there. This one, now no confusion on the possession arrow, goes to Westwood. We have a fan in the crowd trying to start his own defense chant. He's trying.
Interesting how he got that in the building. He got a fence, brought a picket fence in the building, but that's got to appreciate that effort.
More
is someone holding up the D part? Oh, I see. He's got the letter D on the fence. I see.
He doesn't need any help.
I'm getting that now. I'm kind of catching that. This is my little senior moment there. But
Morin drove and was fouled. She hits the first free throw.
I'm sure our defense specialists in the stands will be up again. And
second free throw missed, but an offensive rebound grabbed by Westwood. Nice pass down low by Shagru. Nothing doing there, though. She gets it back. Morin open for three, launches, doesn't knock it down. Gogolin, another rebound.
Well, that's a foul there.
Gogolin cut off there by Connaughton on the baseline. Or not on the baseline, excuse me, on the out-of-bounds line. And a foul there.
Ivy's a tough matchup because she's got wheels, she's got height, and she was determined to go up the sideline. And the number 23, Riley Murray, I think, is the one that got the foul there, or 21, I can't remember.
Connaughton.
Connaughton, my bad.
That's
it.
Her
and
third foul.
She didn't really have enough space to cut her off and created the contact.
Hit with the block.
Again, a lot of players starting to get three fouls for Westwood. That could become an issue.
Keaveney looking for help. Loses the ball and now gets inside to Gogolin. Gogolin, nice pass to Pucci. She muscles it in. Another 2 points for the captain.
Incredible depth. Patience.
Morin dishes out. Shot fired. Knocked down. Caroline Bean, the junior. Westwood able to answer with another three.
They're going to need a few more of those and a few stops to get back in the game here.
Morningstar drives.
What a
nice play. Lily Morningstar.
Left hand.
Dives right through the defense. Another bucket for her.
She's all fired up from being out. Like I said earlier, that was just a beautiful take to the hoop with the left hand.
Three-point shot from Shagru, no good.
Good box
Corby
by Kelly.
Corby grabs the rebound.
Good job, Kelly, keeping things under control.
Keaveney fires the quick three.
Looks like it was
blocked
tipped.
Out of bounds. Not sure if Keaveney knew the situation. Hockington did not have to fire off a shot there. Luckily for the Hillers, they retain possession. We'll have 9.5 seconds left to get a shot.
It was a foul on somebody.
And a push-off on Regan Keaveney.
It's an unusual.
Yeah, a bit odd, not often called. And now Westwood will have a chance to get it to within 11 here.
Coach Greco with a good move to get Emma out of the game. She has three fouls with just the last few seconds of the quarter.
Bonfiglio passes it out. Shot fired. No good from Fiona McGowan, falls well short of the rim. And going into the final quarter of this contest, the Hillers, a 14-point lead, up 51-37.
Well, you know, the first quarter they got 19 points, and then they kind of cooled off a bit in the second quarter, got like 12 points or thereabouts in the second quarter. This third quarter they dumped 20 points on Westwood,
right.
And that's a lot of points
all right, now,
to overcome. So. We have a couple of announcements here.
It's now time to announce the winner of the 50-50 basket tonight. Thank you to all of those that have bought tickets throughout the season. The sports class of 2019 here at the high school. We really appreciate your help. If you're interested in participating next time, we're in all varsity basketball games. So, now the winner. Go ahead, Francesca. And the winning number is 7717552.
Pat Murphy, the suspense was killing me.
One lucky Hiller fan going home with some money tonight.
It's a big crowd here, so hopefully there's a big 50-50 raffle balance in there. And he's
yeah, I imagine must be quite the haul tonight.
Definitely. It looks like we have the Hiller Jazz Band. We don't want to forget about them down there in the end zone there. And they were playing a little Munsters theme. If some of your old-timers remember them. One of my favorite all-time TV shows from the, I don't know, the 70s. I guess it would be the 70s. 60s. Tiger Tarosian is telling me it's before that. It was late 60s. But that's a nice little bandit over there. And they played some good tunes at halftime.
Shagru picking up a quick foul here. Her fourth of the game. And now Hockington will be shooting free throws for the rest of this quarter already.
Yeah, that's a pretty tough development for Westwood, although what it does do, on the other hand, is it keeps the clock, it slows the clock down for the rest of the game, and they're going to need as much time as is available for them to tighten this deficit up.
Misses. Ivy Goglin grabs the offensive board, and another foul. She will shoot too. Ivy Goglin has just been an absolute monster on the offensive glass in particular.
That's a tough matchup for anybody in the Tri-Valley League. And that's also Haley Connaughton's fourth foul. So
her fourth as well, yep. So a lot of trouble here for Westwood as Connaughton now takes a break. Goglin knocks down the first free throw. Second one coming up. Spins out there, but Pucci fighting for the rebound forces another jump ball. Michaela Pucci and Ivy Goglin just getting anything they want inside. That one doesn't result in a Hillers possession, but a great effort there from Pucci nonetheless.
Definitely. She's had quietly probably 8 or 10 points in the game and a lot of really nice little moves underneath. She's a scrappy player, really good skills underneath.
Great pass nice from play. Von Figlia, whips that down to Fiona McGowan, who calmly puts it in for two.
She's only a sophomore. She's got a pretty bright future, too.
Morningstar, a bit too far.
Oh,
there
nice.
Three. Great pass to the cutting Goglin from Pucci. She's definitely in a double-double range now in approaching 20 rebounds.
That's a big game for her tonight, for sure. You know, Westwood, as talented as they are, they don't really have a lot of height.
Three-point shot, oh. No good. Goglin hit with the travel as soon as she hit the ground. Usually you have to move a bit when you do that, but
good again. Point. Yep, good point. But again, if you want to argue with that referee, go right ahead. I'm not going to argue with that guy.
Pass inside.
Ooh, that's a foul.
Goglin hit with the foul there on the turnaround by Elizabeth Kelly.
That was she got all of her money's worth on that foul. That was definitely some contact with the arms were knocking against one another. So.
With how active Goglin has been down low in the post, just her first foul here today.
Well, we got 7 minutes left in the game here. It's still a 14-point lead. It feels like it's been a 14-point lead for quite a long time. I think the Westwood girls got it under under double digits briefly, but it's really – ooh, nice play.
Chagru shot up after the steal on the inbound pass from McGowan. Foul there against Hopkinton. This one on the floor. That one,
that's
the
on
fourth
Emma.
Foul on Emma. Comes back in for a minute, immediately goes back out.
Gee, I thought it was on Pucci, to be honest with you, but that's tough with four fouls. Got to get her out for a few minutes anyway. Emma, I'm talking about Emma.
Chagru with it. She drives. Throws up the shot, another foul called there on Hopkinton.
That's not a bad strategy for Westwood. Is it really the only strategy? They got to get the ball, take it to the hoop, try to draw fouls, keep the clock from moving too quickly, and they're hanging around.
Chagru's first free throw trickles around and falls in. 13-point lead now for Hopkinton, 6:50 left in this game. As Chagru knocks down the second, 6:50 separating the Hillers from another TVL championship.
Oh, too bad.
Turnover there. Canestrari can't control the pass. Catches it. And a backcourt violation, excuse me. Turnover there for Hopkinton.
You don't see that too often with Julia. She took her eye off the ball just long enough to miss that connection.
Chagru, same thing she did last time, steps back for the two-pointer. No good. Morin takes that rebound away. Bonfiglio open, travel there, yep. They are consistent, I will give you that.
Yeah, there's been a lot of them. You know, probably 8 out of 10 of them have been travels, and I'm just estimating my.
Right.
But they certainly have called, feels like a dozen or so of those types of travels tonight, but that one looked like a little travel.
Westwood back in man-to-man defense. They had switched to zone for a little bit to try to get back into this game. Nice pass down low. Knocked out of bounds.
Haley Cotton coming back in with four fouls for
right.
Westwood.
Something to watch.
I mean, they're sort of in a little bit of a desperation mode, down 12 with 6 minutes left.
Morningstar had nowhere to go with it there. Avoids the five-second call, throws it in. Luckily, ball knocked out of bounds off of a Wolverine, and the Hillers retain. Corby inside to Gogol, and she turns around, fires. Can't get it to fall, and Connaughton grabs the rebound. Connaughton pass. Luckily, Pucci turns her head around, takes the steal, and another foul there. Was that one on Shagru? That would be her fifth.
I don't think it was on her. I think it was on Elizabeth Kelly.
And that's her fourth.
Yeah, and that's her fourth. So, yeah, there's been so many foul calls. Eventually there's going to get have players with three and four fouls. And
As of now, the Wolverines have three girls out there with four fouls. Connaughton, Kelly, and Shagru. Eventually, one of them is going to foul out. You would think.
Well, they're still kind of hanging around with down by a dozen.
Yep, Hopkinton not hitting the free throws to put them away.
Oh, nice
great
play.
Great pass inside. Bonfiglio converts on the and one with a chance to bring it to with their deficit within single digits.
Well, that was a nice sort of backdoor move, and Julia got caught a little bit, and not her fault. She, you know, this Bonfiglio, number 15 for Westwood, made a nice cut, and she had a really nice finish, and Julian got her on the arm on the way up.
Free throw good. Now Westwood back within single digits, down nine with 5.5 minutes left. Canestrari passes it inside to Gogolin, now inside to Pucci. Morningstar for three, steps inside for a two, too strong, grabbed by Bonfiglio. Morin for three, knocks it down.
I would call a timeout here.
Timeout here for Coach Greco.
All of a sudden it's 6 points. It was at 17 earlier.
Right.
And there's a lot of time left, so the Hillers have to kind of gather themselves. It's a really good timeout by Coach Greco.
Yep, the three-point shot really keeping Westwood in this game. And the free throws on the other side for the Hillers allowing Westwood to stay in this game. Hopkinton should have still a 10-point lead in this one, but the free throws have failed them, as has been their Achilles heel all season. But fortunately for them, it hasn't affected them because, like we've talked about earlier, they've had a lot of blowouts in this game.
Yeah, definitely. And I'm not sure what you're referring to, Mike. the defense. I'm sorry.
Yeah, hopefully we see some more of that there from the Hillers.
Well, they're gonna need some our director and the producer rather Mike Tarosian helping us out here with the gentleman with the defense. They need more of that because certainly the Westwood girls are starting to launch them and have really cut the deficit down to a respectable 6 points. And right now, I would say it's anyone's game. The Hillers have a little cushion, but the momentum. The pendulum has swung in Westwood's favor in the last couple minutes.
We'll see what type of resolve these Hiller girls have here with 5 minutes left up for the majority of this game, for the entirety of this game. Let's see if they can complete the victory. Canestrari drives.
Nice.
Aggressive play. Canestrari.
That was a huge hoop. But there's the defense coming up there.
Julia Canestrari taking it into her own hands, cuts right through the defense for another bucket for her. She has played fantastic this game. Morningstar with the defense on Morin. Great defense all around from Hopkinton. Callie Corby.
5 seconds on the shot clock.
Shot fired from Shagru, no good. Morningstar
nice
rips the rebound away. Now ball finally gets over half court there.
Good composure by the Hillers, bringing the ball up, taking care of the ball.
Morningstar controlling things now offensively. She drives, throws it right off of a Wolverine, off of Bonfiglio.
Get Emma coming back in with four fouls. Callie Corby, really nice job by Callie tonight.
Mm-hmm. Hasn't really reflected on the stat sheet necessarily, but her presence has been important.
No mistakes, doing everything she's supposed to be doing out there.
Bonfiglio hits the floor hard, gets up, seems to be okay.
Well,
Hillers did not notice the shot clock winding down. Maybe some help from the fans there. That's what home court advantage is for.
Yeah, well, I think the entire crew here didn't realize there was a shot clock violation going on right in front of us, but certainly a good development for Westwood at the moment.
Bonfiglio, the deep three. Gets nothing there. Lands out of bounds.
Well, she's not shy, but, you know, they have to start. They're down by eight. 3:45 left in the game. They're going to need to hit a couple bombs here to get back in, I think.
Canestrari controlling it for Hockington. Now back in the hands of Morningstar. Golden, the nice fake, turns around, shot, no good. Morningstar pokes that ball away. No Hiller can grab it, though. In the hands of Shagru, she drives the whole way, not stopped, can't finish.
Nice
Golden,
play.
Another rebound. Now Morningstar finds Pucci. Canestrari thought about the three. Drives now to Pucci. Pucci baseline. Blocked from behind, she gets her own rebound.
Oh.
And one, Michaela Pucci. Gets the circus shot to go.
That ball came down wet. That was above the backboard. It was
a big reaction.
Incredible shot. You know, had a little English on it. That's just her game.
That is the essence of Michaela Pucci's game right there. She muscles it in, gets her first opportunity, misses, grabs it again, takes a foul and converts. That has been the story of Michaela Pucci for her entire career here at Hockington.
Well, yeah, I mean, as we've seen a lot this season, she just works that baseline so well, and she didn't have a whole lot of room to get that first shot off,
way.
And then and good defensive on the play in the first shot there, and then she got her own rebound or from the block and sort of. Well, a wing and a prayer kind of launched it up there, and the ball had a lot of spin on it, and somehow it found its way through the net.
Now a chance for a three-point play. Pucci calmly knocks it down, 11-point lead now.
That's a big development right there.
Well, I wondered how the Hockington girls would respond after the lead got to within six, and so far they have responded very well. Still time, though, for Westwood.
Oh!
That foul would have put Connaughton out of the game. Morningstar thought she drew the charge. No such luck, though, for the Hiller faithful here. Connaughton will be shooting.
That's one of those. That was a tweener there. Hard to say if she had both feet. We don't have the instant replay here, but it was a really close play in terms of the having her feet planted.
First free throw good for Connaughton.
By the sound of the Hiller crowd, they felt that was an offensive foul. That would have been a tough call for Haley Connaughton. But she's at the line with two shots, and she hits them both.
Now a 9-point lead for Hockington.
Westwood looking
LaKasha
to double.
LaKasha at the three-point line. They are doubling every time. Gogolin turns around, fires a shot, no good. Bonfiglio with the rebound. Morin drives, now in the hands of Shagru. Connaughton fires the three, too strong. Gogolin can't quite get the rebound. First one she hasn't snagged. Shagru did a little hop step there. Usually referees let that go if you shoot it after, but she drove and hit with the travel.
That one to me didn't look too bad. And at this point in the game, ooh.
LaKasha there.
I think they're double bonus territory, so there's going to be.
Forces the issue and draws a foul for Morin. Yeah, and you're right, they should be shooting two here. LaKasha the senior, some big free throws coming up for her. off the mark on the first one.
Well, you give Westwood a lot of credit here. They're coming in on the road against really one of the top teams in the state.
Lakasha knocks down the second timeout, Coach Greco. 10-point lead for the Hillers with 2:09 remaining.
Yeah, that, I don't know what kind of, what the Westwood girls can come up with to tighten this lead up. You know, it's got one possession at a time, as they say, and they need a big hoop and they need a couple stops. So,
well, yeah. I'd say after the recent string of blowouts, we definitely got our money's worth here tonight, wouldn't you?
I would definitely say that, and you know, it's a Friday night here, and. I know the Hillers have a couple more games coming up after this, or?
That's right, yep. Coming up next, they will be heading to Westboro for the Westboro Invitational Tournament. That starts on Sunday. And should they win that first game, they will play again on the 21st, Tuesday. And the championship will take place on the 23rd, on Thursday, assuming everything goes well for the Hillers. But last year, they did win it. So this year, I mean, and especially with the way that they've been performing, I would expect some success in that as well. But right now, they certainly have their hands full with Westwood, one of the top teams in the TVL.
Well, you know, as I said, Westwood has been a formidable opponent tonight, and they're still in it. There's 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter at the moment, and the Hillers need to dig down right now.
Morin thought about the three, was turned away. Shagru looking to get rid of it.
That's a walk. Ooh.
Ivy Gogolin hit with the blocking foul there. More free throws coming. Now two free throws coming for Carly Shagru.
Yep. That's actually on Michaela, her fourth.
Oh, Poochie, excuse me.
Yep. And I thought there was a travel before that, but.
Like you said, 8 out of 10 travels.
Yep. Ooh,
That's a tough free throw there. Shagru's just rims out.
There's no room for any misses at the free throw for them at this point in the game. And
only 1:49 left. They need every point they can get. Second one good for Shagru.
Good job by Emma. Bringing the ball up under some significant pressure.
Gogolin inside. Morningstar with it. Now Wisely pulls it back. Still time to waste here on the shot clock, up 9. Akasha drives. A quick jump ball there. Tied up for a little bit.
Still a Hiller ball with a possession arrow. 9 seconds left in the shot clock. We have to make a note of that because we missed the last time.
Morningstar struggling to get it in. She does find Canestrari. Gets it into Gogol. And now Morningstar with it. 3 seconds left. Gogolin quick has to turn around and shoot. She does. Does not hit the rim. A shot clock violation there. Good effort there from Gogolin, but nothing doing on that last ditch attempt. Westwood takes over.
I would say they need a big hoop right here. Westwood does. Hillers are fired up on defense. You can see that. Digging in.
Morin driving against Morningstar.
Oh, nice.
The tough layup. She can't finish.
Ooh.
Lily Morningstar hit with a reach and foul. She was incensed about that one. I have to say I agree. Tough foul there to call.
Yeah, I didn't see a whole lot going on there. I mean, the Westwood girl fell down. I thought it was more incidental, and she kind of lost her balance more than anything. And Lily, pretty calm individual, but she was a little
fired up after that.
Fired
one,
up
for
that
sure.
Questioning that call, but you know, it's still. You know, a relatively comfortable 9-point lead with 1:04 left, and what a great game! And again, as you said earlier, this could be a celebratory Friday night here if they win. They're the Tri Valley League champs of 2016-2017 mm-hmm. season, which you don't get those too often, right?
Right. The TVL always a very tough conference. We have Millis, who is consistently fielding a good team, winners of the D4 state champions the past few years. Westwood, again, always a good team. Medway, always, again, puts a good team out on the court. So there's always a lot
Medfield
of
Medfield, too. You know?
Medfield, exactly, yeah. Right. Medfield is the only Hillers TVL loss this season, which we saw them Hopkinton kind of give one away earlier in the season. But since then, they really have been playing well. And their last loss to Coyle Cassidy, 13 games ago. Now the Hillers looking to end this season with a 13th win in a row in that TVL championship that you mentioned. First free throw missed from Caroline Bean. Second one here. And like you said, they can't afford any misses. And they've gone two of four, I believe, in the last four free throws because they knocked down that one. Quick foul there from Morn on Lakasha. Now we will see the Hillers try to make some, which, as we've documented before, not their strongest suit.
Well, again, it's not over yet, but the 8 points is a pretty significant amount of, you know, points to overcome. I say that, but both teams are in a double bonus, but Westwood's going to have to foul quickly whenever the Hiller girls get the ball.
Lakasha's first free throw rims out. Second one hits the back.
That's
Pucci with a big rebound.
And
a smart play. Normally, Pucci goes right back up with it. She kicked it out knowing. And now Morningstar fouled, and she will have a chance. That's a back-breaking layup there. A rebound there for the Hillers.
Yeah, Ivy's, like you said, I think she has got to have a dozen points and about 15, 18 rebounds or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
We'll kind of lose track here. Which is a good thing. When you can't keep track of them, that's a good sign that there's a lot of points and rebounds, racking up there. So
Morningstar, the sophomore, calmly knocks down the first free throw, not fazed by this moment. Second one off the back rim. Gogolin gets her hands on it, but grabbed by Bean. 45 seconds and counting now. Hiller's up 9. Bonfiglio thought about the 3. Now she fires. Nothing there.
Oh, nice play by
Morningstar. Grabs the rebound. Might have stepped on the end line. Not called.
Little tiptoeing on the baseline. She did a great job keeping her balance and staying in bounds in that play.
Now Lakasha will have a chance for redemption. 2 more free throws coming up.
And that's her 5th foul, number 10, Haley Connaughton.
It's about time she fouled out, because when we were talking about her 4th foul, I think at the start of this 4th quarter, great play by her there to avoid that fatal 5th foul as Lakasha knocks down that first free throw. Opening up a double-digit lead now for Hopkinton. 36 seconds left. 2 in a row there for Lakasha. Big free throws. 11-point lead now.
Coach Greco calls a quick timeout to gather everybody. They have an 11-point, it's now comfortable lead, I'd say, with 35.9 seconds left. And let's just not do anything, that could put themselves in jeopardy. I don't know how that could happen at this point.
We've seen Westwood hit those threes, though. That has kept them in the game thus far. A quick 3, maybe some missed free throws, and we'll see. We'll see if Westwood can make this one any closer and take away Hopkinton's first TVL championship in over 10 years.
Well, that's going to take a minor miracle for that to happen, but 11-point lead. The Hillers, I don't know what they have planned if they win this game and take the championship, but it doesn't, like I said, doesn't happen too often, and it's a Friday night, full house. Maybe there'll be some sort of a celebratory situation after the game. But, it's not like the season's over. They have unfinished business to do after this game.
Absolutely.
And I'm sure they want to do some damage in the playoffs and in the Westboro tournament. And it looks like the student body's starting to stand up. They're
getting behind the Hillers here with 30 seconds left. This might be the last chance for Westwood. If they don't score, the game might be over. Looks like all the bench players are in. Most of them are in. 3 fired there from Riley Murray. No good. Pucci had it, lost it. Now back in the hands of Murray. 2-point shot, no good. And it looks like Westwood has conceded this one. Gogolin grabs another rebound. Now Canestrari brings it across half court. And your Hopkinton Hillers are your 2016-2017 TVL champions with a win over Westwood 63-52.
And here's that celebratory situation I was referring to earlier.
A minor court storming.
That's great. They're fired up. Student body has gone into the floor, and the referees are trying to contain them. I don't know if that's going to happen or not, but they have to do the traditional handshake, which is nice. Westwood, great job by Westwood. tonight. They came in, fired up. They ran into a really tough Hoppington team. Mm-hmm. And Hoppington did what they had to do to take care of business, and they're the Tri-Valley League champs.
Westwood drops to 14-5 overall, 11-4 in the TVL. They play on Sunday in the Riley Winter Classic against Fontbonne. That's on Sunday at 3 o'clock, and Hoppington improves to 16-2 overall, 16-1 in the TVL. A great season, obviously evidenced by them taking home the title this year. And they, like we said before, will play in Westboro in the Westboro Invitational Tournament on Sunday the 19th at 5 p.m.
Yeah, they look fired up. They just ran off the court with a little swagger in their step, and I'm sure there could be some, I don't know, I don't want to predict anything, but it could be a massive pizza party or something going on tonight. I'm sure they're going to be celebrating. So congratulations to them, and that was a really fun telecast tonight. Thanks to our crew one more time. You want to take care of that, Tim?
Sure thing. Our producers, John Ritz and Mike Tarosian. Director, Tom Dings. On graphics, Samantha Dings. Cameras, John Ritz, Andy Ritz, and Mike Tarosian. Once again, congratulations to the 2016-2017 TVL champions, your Hoppington Hillers. We hope to see you here for a playoff game coming up. Thanks, guys.